hopefully you guys enjoyed last night, and I appreciate you guys waking up to continue on today. We do have a fantastic day ahead of us still, and there's a lot of topics here that hopefully will be very relevant to the individual regions, and we'd like to spend some time on that this morning as well. And I'm going to apologize, for last night. We had invited Andrew Lum to come speak and really wanted him to share his thoughts. Like, we think he's actually a very excellent speaker and writer. Unfortunately, the setting last night was not very conducive to that. So we've actually called him, and he's been very gracious enough to come back today, and we'll be here at 11:30. So what we're going to do is shift around the programming a little bit so that we finish this next section at 11:30 and have him come back, talk to us a little bit more. So hopefully you guys will enjoy that and give him your attention when he does come. So in addition to that, so the next block of time here, what we'd like to do is actually focus on what is most helpful for each region. You know, like we have a theme in company building local power. We've talked a lot about personal leadership and organizational management skills. So what's the next step? You know, so it's to go back to your regions, figure out what goes well, what doesn't go well, how can we improve that? And this is realizing that, you know, a lot of the groups here are VSAs or UVSAs or other groups. You know, it's not all necessarily the same, but the direction we're trying to encourage here is, regardless of what name you have or organizational affiliation, let's try to figure out for our community what's the best partner with, or to just think about communicating more with, at the bare minimum, so that, for example, we're not scheduling events right next to each other, so that you know, people have to make a tough choice, but rather space it out or something like that. But in addition to that, there's a lot of other specific questions that some of the regions may have that you think other people may have some answers to that might be helpful to you. So we're going to divide this up into first breaking out into your individual regions, and for those regions, I think that, and we're going to make it up to you, but it'll be, the point will be to have at least all the regions that are large enough to sustain their own discussion, where it's productive enough where you can take it back and do something. We'd encourage you to set up your separate regional discussion. For those that feel that, you know, you only have a couple people here, or, you know, it's not the right group and you just want to learn about kind of more general topics, we'll have a table there as well and discuss some issues there. So with that, I think as soon as we can load up, we have, you know, technically there's this regional map. I don't know if anybody's seen it, but we've divided up North America into 11 different regions. And roughly, I guess we can wait till the map gets up on the screen, but it's the Pacific Northwest, Northern California, Southern California, Texas, Midwest, which is like everything from Ohio, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, and then we have Southeast, Georgia, Florida, a lot of those states down there, Louisiana, part of Texas, the South region, actually, and not Texas. New England is, you know, Boston, New York, Maine. And what else? I think there's an eastern region, which includes like Pennsylvania and some of the Atlantic states and stuff. But why don't we try and just break up into those logical groups here, and then actually identify people in each group to kind of moderate the discussion. So if I ask you all to self-organize.
No.
All right, let's have Georgia here, NorCal, this area, SoCal in the back corner, Midwest in right there. and you guys should raise your hand, there's yours. Texas and New Orleans, right there. Do you have enough to hold your own, or? All right, so, other regions, why don't you come up here and then just like other regions, if you don't have one right now, just come up to the very front and I'll help you figure it out where it makes sense.
In Southern California, we actually have two youth festivals. UVSA hosts a large, festival in Orange County. Teamwork is empowerment. 2 years ago, a couple of alumni from UVSA came up to San Diego. We want to empower San Diego to do their own festival. Last year, we personal contact, you go to people. Wrote all the organization in the community, all the adult organization. I'm glad to do that by personally talking to them. We have our own challenges too. There are certain adult community organizations who have been, you know,
but that time,
down there, and we can be able to survive. And working together, the goal is building a new generation for our community. Everywhere, if you have the vision, anyway. Thank you.
Schools, because that's the schools that's being represented today. So, Georgia Tech, GA, and UCF. So, we do really well. Georgia Tech is, we have this fundraising event every year. It's called the Charity Dinner, where we get many different volunteers from different schools to come and put on like a show, like a show. We sing, we dance, and we have a lot of people there, and we have a lot of money, and that money was recently, you know, one of the members, he went back to Vietnam and bought a lot of school supplies for who are, you know, less fortunate, had students that were very unfortunate.
About the days and holidays and the meetings of these events.
So and what we do extremely well, we had to go through it by hands by reason because we had to work out that way. So you see, Berkeley, you know, has a great mentorship program where it's kind of like the little girls. And they also focus a lot on officers, on building their cabinet strength. So they have a very strong core leadership that works very well. Sacramento organizes cultural shows very well, right? And they also very good at bringing attendance to those events. And San Jose State, I mean, San Jose area, yeah, we have a lot of access to local resources. I mean, we're kind of like getting on three. So it's really a lot of local activity that we have access to that we need to utilize. And those were kind of the points that we focused on.
For people who are joining late, it's okay they came late. I won't get mad at you. Or put you out. Anyways, go to the regional caucus. So find your region and join them. And we're just discussing things that we can learn from one another within our region and sharing amongst the larger groups. We've already talked about what's gone well. I think one of the most productive things, though, is that there's also a lot of common hurdles, right? And let's talk about next. Just brainstorm real quick, take 5 minutes to list out what you dislike or what could be improved. Just brainstorm a couple of ideas.
From Georgia, one is recruitment and retention. Communities are strange, non-compliant, adults are not supportive. We need to keep them interested, and that's one of the challenges we face. Second thing is fundraising within the school, within the community, some demographical challenge as far as Vietnamese population not high enough. Athens, the community is very sparse. Third thing, communication. Leaders' translation of goals and vision to members. Sometimes they're not on the same page. Staff have different goals than members. And then individual activism is also different.
Good, thank you.
Next is other students outside of the VSA do not feel welcome. So that's related to people joining the VSAs and stuff like that. And three is apathy from other students, perhaps in the club or outside of the club.
Thank you.
Okay, our big problem is that the community is kind of spread out, and like for Indiana, the Vietnamese community is like big cities like Chicago and Indianapolis, but Purdue is like an hour away, so we have that separation of distance. It's hard to stay involved. Also, the generation gap, where our parents, they don't really, not that they're not supportive, but they don't really understand our motivations for wanting to build up VSAs. They're more concerned with our schooling and things of that nature. And also membership retention, members, they want something out of it. They are more like, they want something in return, right? And so before they put in the work, they want to know that they're going to get something back. And also there's a transition
for the VSA, the slides for the West region, and also New Orleans. There, we have to say apathy among like political causes, activism, and just involvement, basically. The involvement in the university community can also be, improved. And we have also insulation, which means that within our organization, it's more that our organizations are compact and that people can't really get to us. A lot of times people hesitate to join our organization because we are so, tight-knit and close that nobody else really wants to join it. They just start fresh, I guess. So that, and then also the lack of vision among leaders and vision for organization.
Lead the way.
So a transitional project.
something that I'm always trying to do is to not things go forward is to have the retreats. This is a group where we get to know each other and to understand each other strength and weakness, so they can all help each other.
High school tuition program that's
and they invest in their emotional investment.
Well, actually, we haven't done that very well in the past, so this will be our first year in the fall. We're planning to throw a formal alumni banquet, and we went to our student office to get the name for the past officers, and then we're going to try to branch out from there. We also created a online network.
Just that it was
sit there and personally talk with is because there's a feeling that is that something more than just like, you know, you say person and you
also
all that, I think, all the money out there, this is finding ways to get to it.
All right, so